My name is Amander Clark, and I'm at the University of California, Los Angeles, in the Eli and Edith Byrd Center for Regenerative Medicine and Stem Cell Research. I'm a stem cell biologist, and I'm interested in building models to understand human infertility. We've been doing this research at UCLA since 2006, so almost a decade. We've been focusing very hard on how to build these cell types from stem cells so that we can then determine how they grow and how they specialize into that very special cell type, the egg and the sperm cell, that's responsible for our reproductive health. And also to understand what makes them develop incorrectly. So if you expose these cells to environmental toxins, does it cause them to stop developing? So we're very interested in how that could be impacting the reproductive health of the human population. So I grew up in a small country town in Australia. I grew up on a farm. I was the first person in my family to attend university, so I went to the University of Melbourne. That is where I obtained my PhD. I came to the United States as a 26-year-old, and it was the third time I'd been on an airplane in my entire life, so it was really starting a whole new life with two suitcases. And I started my postdoctoral fellowship at Baylor College of Medicine because I wanted to learn more about genetic models. And from there, I did a second postdoctoral fellowship at UCSF in California, and that's where I learned stem cell models. And then finally, I came to UCLA in 2006 in order to start my own research laboratory. Around 6.1 million women and their partners in the United States suffer from infertility every year. It is a large problem in society, and I think we don't hear so much about it because infertility doesn't kill you. It's a devastating disease, and when couples suffer from infertility, they're often very quiet about it. And so it's about time a spotlight was shone on this area of research, and that requires creative thinking and building new models and new tools to understand infertility. And so that's where my lab's research fits into this area. So a stem cell is a biological tool, so it's not a device that we would think about chemists making or physicists. This is a biological product where we are developing the process, but the product is the ability to differentiate egg and sperm cells from stem cells. And so that would be a usable product in a basic science research lab in order to understand human reproductive health. So the tool that we're generating begins with human stem cells, which are growing in a cell culture incubator. In order to make the germline cells from these stem cells, we will take the stem cells and we'll move them to a different tissue culture plate, and they will grow in an environment that has lots of cytokines and molecules that will promote the formation of the human germline from these stem cells. And then when we want to look at the germline cells, we have to use some pretty sophisticated machines. We can use microscopes. We use a machine called a fluorescence activated cell sorter, where we label the germline cells and then we shoot them through liquid and put them into tubes, and we do various molecular assays on them to prove that they are germ cells, and then to be able to use sequencing approaches to look at the entire complement of RNAs that are found in these cells. We study their genome, and we also study the proteins that these cells make as well.
So this is looking at receptors that are found on the surface of these 18 stem cell lines that we made here at UCLA. So what I'm looking at is for similarities and differences between the stem cell lines. And so you can see here, this stem cell line is very different than blue. We're focusing on the blue. And so this might tell us something about whether we see a difference in the outcome when we use that stem cell line versus this stem cell line. And so these are the sort of questions we're trying to address, given that all stem cell lines are unique and different.
There's a lot of terrific questions that have no answers right now, and they have no answers because there's no model. And the stem cells, we think, we feel very strongly that stem cells will provide us with the missing model to understand human reproductive health.